This video has been rated TVMA for "This video is mostly ass." Viewer discretion is advised. I've got a dirty little secret. I love conspiracy theories. And I love them not just because they're entertaining in and of themselves, but because it says a lot about the people who believe in them, as well as the people that don't believe in them. Now, as for me personally, when I think about a particular conspiracy theory, I like to keep two things in mind. The first one is, just because you're paranoid doesn't mean nobody's out to get you.
I have come to. We have to exterminate white people off of the face of the planet to solve this problem. That we need to solve this problem because they are going to kill us.
Now, that guy you just saw, is he out of his mind? Yeah, he's probably out of his damn mind. But does he have a point? Yeah. For instance, Charles Darwin, in his Descent of Man, written in the mid-1800s, advocated that the white man, or the Caucasian, should, or will probably, eliminate the savage races, such as, in his words, the Negro, the Hottentot, the Aboriginal, Australian Aborigine. Eliminate the savage races of the world and replace them with his own civilized race. Charles Darwin. Then there was Margaret Sanger of Planned Parenthood. She founded Planned Parenthood, who started the Negro Project, which, for lack of better terminology, wanted to thin out the herd. Wanted to kind of eliminate a lot of the black people that they were seeing pouring into the cities at the time from the South. Now, are these isolated? No. The U.S. government, from 1932 to 1972, performed a medical experiment on black men in Tuskegee, Alabama. And this is one of them they found out about. These men had syphilis, and the U.S. government faked medical treatments to them in order to study them, like so many guinea pigs. And the bad thing about it was the cure for syphilis was found in 1947. These men suffered for decades.
This man did, pulled him aside and said, "Now, Mr. Nix, what did the Warren Commission say? Where did they say these shots came from?"
"From the blood depository."
And they said, "That's right, and that's what we want you to say."
The clip you just saw was, of course, about the assassination of President John F. Kennedy. That was the granddaughter of Orville Nix. Orville Nix was a man who had a movie camera right there at the assassination. Much like Abraham Zapruder, except that he got the opposite side. He was on the other side of Kennedy when it happened, when he got shot. This clip is about how he was treated by CBS when he went in for an interview in 1967, just a little bit before the Warren Commission came out with their report about how Lee Harvey Oswald did the whole damn thing, how he was the lone nut with the magic bullet, etc., etc., etc. Now, Nix was going to say that he was pretty sure that he heard these shots coming from somewhere else, and as you can see, CBS cut him off at the knees and said, "Nah, this is what's the way it's going to be. If you're famous at all, and you say something like, you know, maybe Lee Harvey Oswald didn't do the whole thing, CBS, ABC will call you an idiot. As a matter of fact, everybody will call you an idiot because there's no way, right?" Well, except, of course, the government itself, the House Select Committee on Assassinations, found in the 1970s that, yeah, it was a conspiracy. Not a lot of people like to talk about that. Now, Earlier, I had told you that there were two things that I always like to keep in mind when I consider a particular conspiracy theory. We've seen about the first one. The second one is, never attribute to malice what can be adequately explained by stupidity. Currently, the most prevalent of these conspiracy theories is the 9/11 truth movement, which ranges all the way from Bush knew about it before it happened, all the way up to the freaky ass, oh, cruise missiles with holograms wrapped around them and laser beams on their freaking heads zapped holes into the World Trade Center while planes landed elsewhere and with the passengers that went off to Bogota and were paid millions of dollars, not to say, hey, get the fuck out of here. But George W. Bush doesn't get blamed for everything. An oldie but goodie is blaming the Jewish people for everything. Like wanting to take over the world, or being vampires, or some shit like that. And the funny part about it being that even Jewish people can't agree on who's Jewish and who's not Jewish. Then you got some whack jobs out there who aren't content with stopping at George W. Bush and Jewish people taking over the world. They think that there's a whole bunch of other groups that want to take over the world, or controlling the Jewish people and George Bush, like, for instance, lizard aliens. Lizard people disguised as human beings. David Icke here, for instance, no, he's not a lizard guy, but he and lots of people who believe him think that these lizard people want to take over the world and eat everybody on it. Now, okay, granted, I've had some fantasies. But, for the most part, what the fuck? Look out, James Kirk! Your technology can't help you now! About the only conspiracy theory and conspiracy theorists that piss me off are these little snot-nosed new atheists that say, oh, America's turning into a theocracy with all these Christians. Shut the fuck up. You know, all these assholes have got to do all day long is to find statues and monuments and shit to try to get rid of them and look at the back of the money and go, in God we trust. Oh, God! Oh, 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 it's God! Look at that! Oh, damn. And they even look at the crosses, these memorial crosses, and they want to get rid of them. You know, what are they fucking afraid of? That the president might offer a prayer or something? Oops. It wouldn't be so bad if they didn't pull other assholes like lawyers, like the ACLU, for instance, into the whole thing. People in the ACLU like Nadie Strossen, Dorothy M. Ehrlich, Stephen Shapiro, Jewish names, remove crosses.